Hi everybody, the channel Knowledge Academy welcomes you. In this video, we are going to discuss about pre-coded duo binary scheme. Okay, so what is meant by this? Why do we go for this technique? Let us discuss. So here in the previous video, we were talking about duo binary signaling or correlative coding. Okay, so it is a practical method of achieving theoretical maximum transmission rate. Okay, so that is correlative coding. By artificially introducing inter-symbol interference, we can achieve that. Since the impact of inter-symbol interference is known, we can easily rectify that in the receiver side. Okay, so that is duo binary signaling. So what happens in duo binary signaling, there is a disadvantage, that is if a bit is wrongly predicted, then all the other bits preceding that will not be identified correctly. So there is a disadvantage of duo binary signaling. Okay, so in order to avoid that disadvantage, we go for pre-coded duo binary scheme, in which we code the sequence, the binary sequence that is entering into the transmitter or entering into the duo binary scheme. Before applying this technique, duo binary signaling, we are going to code it using a technique, and then to that code word or to that code, we are going to apply duo binary scheme. Okay, so what happens if a bit is wrongly identified? Only that bit will be affected. The remaining bits will not be, the bits which are proceeding will not be affected in any manner. Okay, so that is pre-coded duo binary scheme. So let us see how we are going to do it in further discussion. So before entering into the further discussion, subscribe my channel Knowledge Academy. Now let us go for further discussion. Okay, so what happens in pre-coded duo binary scheme? The input binary sequence. So this is input binary sequence, which are zeros and ones. Zeros and ones, they are entering into this block. Okay, so here modulo 2 addition is performed, which is nothing but XOR operation. Okay, so the output of this XOR operation or output of this block is AK. This AK is transmitted to one of the inputs of XOR operation, modulo 2 adder, through this feedback path passing through this delay block. Okay, so here the delay block produces an output of AK minus 1. So it's because since the output of modulo 2 adder is AK, this delay block which is present in the feedback path produces an output of AK minus 1. That AK minus 1 is given as an input to modulo, is given as one of the inputs to modulo 2 adder. Another input is the binary sequence that is entering, okay, which is the actual message signal that has to be transmitted. Okay, so we are going to pre-code this. We are going to code this actual message signal, which are zeros and ones, through this modulo 2 adder, and this code, this encoded, this coded binary sequence is called as AK, is defined as AK here. Okay, so what is AK? AK equal to BK plus AK minus 1. Okay, so AK minus 1 is the output of this delay block, and between BK is the input binary sequence. Between this input binary sequence and the delayed version of AK, we are performing modulo 2 addition. Okay, so it is nothing but XOR operation. We are performing XOR operation, and to that AK, we are applying duo binary signaling scheme. Okay, we are going to apply duo binary technique to that AK. Okay, and after that, our final output of our duo binary transmitter is CK, which we are transmitting through the channel. Okay, so this is the thing. So due to this, what happens, what are the things that are going to happen, and how this BK is transmitted in the form of, is represented in the form of amplitude levels using this pre-coded duo binary scheme, let us see. Okay, what happens, this AK, it is the modulo 2 addition between BK and AK minus 1. Okay, so AK minus 1 can be either 0 or 1. Similarly, BK can be either 0 or 1. Okay, when we do modulo 2 addition or XOR operation between these two BK, between these BK and AK minus 1, what do we have? So XOR operation means when both the inputs are same, the output is 0. When both the inputs are different, the output is 1. So here, when both the inputs are same, the output is 0. Again, here, when both the inputs are 1, the output is 0. Okay, and when both the inputs are different, the output is 1. Here, when both the inputs are different, here it is 0, here it is 1. So the output is 1. Okay, again, when both the inputs are different, the output is 1. When both the inputs are different, so here it is 1, here BK is 0. So the inputs are different. So the in the corresponding box, the output is given as 1. Okay. Now, we have filled AK inside the box. Okay. So the values inside the box represent AK. Okay. So to this AK, we are going to apply duo binary scheme. Now, pre-coding is over. To this AK, we have to apply duo binary scheme. Okay. So before that, we have to let us represent these values AK in the form of unipolar non-return to zero line coding format. Okay. So what happens? We have to transmit that bit values into amplitude levels. Okay. Using unipolar non-return. So not unipolar. So a polar non-return to zero. Okay. So polar non-return to zero means the value zeros are represented by an amplitude level of minus 1 volt, and the bit value ones are represented by an amplitude level of plus 1 volt. Okay. So that is what I have done here. Okay. So this zero is represented as minus 1 volt. This one is represented as 1 volt. One is represented as 1 volt, and zero is represented as minus 1 volt. Okay, zeros are represented by minus 1 volt, and ones are represented as plus 1 volt. Now we are going to apply duo binary scheme or duo binary signaling to this AK. So what happens? CK equal to AK plus AK minus 1. AK plus AK minus 1. Here we are not doing XOR operation or modulo 2 addition. Here it is direct addition. Okay. So already we have discussed this in duo binary scheme. Okay. So what happens? CK equal to AK plus AK minus 1. Okay. So here we have AK inside the boxes. Okay. And AK minus 1 outside. Okay. And when AK minus 1 is 0, it is represented by an amplitude level of minus 1 volt. And when AK minus 1 is 1, it is represented with an amplitude level of plus 1 volt. Okay. Now to this, we are going to apply duo binary scheme. Okay. And the values of AK are given inside the boxes, inside these boxes. Okay. Now we have to fill CK inside these boxes. Okay. So for this box, okay, what happens to the value of AK? AK is minus 1 volt, and the value of AK minus 1 is also minus 1 volt. So minus 1 volt, minus 1 volt, it is minus 2 volt. Okay, CK is minus 2 volt now. Okay. Now for this box, the value of AK is 1 volt. The value of AK minus 1 is minus 1 volt. So 1 volt minus 1 volt, it is 0 volt. Right, the corresponding box of CK is 0 volt. Similarly, the value of AK here is 1 volt, and the value of AK minus 1 is 1 volt here. So 1 volt plus 1 volt, 1 volt plus 1 volt is 2 volt. Okay, and again, the value of AK minus 1 in this box is minus 1 volt, and the value of AK minus 1 is 1 volt. So minus 1 volt plus 1 volt in the corresponding box of CK, it becomes 0 volt. Now let us compare the values of CKs with BK. Okay. So what happens when CK, for the value of BK equal to 0, CK becomes either minus 2 volt or 2 volt. Okay. Whenever the value of BK is 1, CK becomes either 0 volt or 0 volt. So the higher phase value of the binary digit is represented by 0 volt, whereas the lower phase value of binary digit is represented by a higher amplitude level, plus or minus 2 volt, whereas the higher phase value is represented by lower amplitude level. Okay. So here a non-linear coordination is happening. Okay. So this is how, this is input by, this is the actual input binary sequence. So for the input binary sequence, after pre-coded duo binary scheme, the output becomes, for BK equal to 0, it is plus or minus 2 volt, and for BK equal to 1, it becomes 0 volt. Okay, no amplitude level, 0 amplitude level. Okay, so this is regarding a pre-coded duo binary scheme. Okay, what happens if any of the bit is wrongly detected, it affects only the value of AK and not BK. BK is not affected. Okay, while in while detecting, okay, CK is transmitted through the channel and the receiver receives CK, and CK has to be processed in order to get the original sequence BK. So what happens during this process, CK has to be decoded. During this process, what happens if any of the bit or any of the sample of CK is wrongly detected, it affects only AK and it does not affect BK, which is the required signal, okay, because BK is transmitted and the estimation of BK should be very well matched so that a correct communication has established. We can conclude like that, okay. But what happens here, duo binary scheme, what happens, CK becomes CK depends on BK minus 1, and if any of BK minus 1 is wrongly detected, then BK is wrongly detected, and that BK becomes BK minus 1 for the next sample, and again the wrong detection goes further and further and it affects the entire communication. So once a bit is wrongly detected, the wrong detection goes further, okay, will affect the entire communication. Here only that particular bit is affected, okay. So that is the thing here. CK in the receiver side, what happens, it is passed through the rectifier, and rectifier, it avoids the pulsating components and it gives a clean value, okay. So this rectifier helps to reshape the received signal, and then modulus of CK is given through a threshold detector. So here what happens, the threshold detector has a threshold value of 1 volt. So 1 volt, 1 volt is the threshold value. If the received signal is greater than this 1 volt, okay, so what happens if CK is the received signal, if CK is greater than this 1 volt, okay, the decision is made in favor of symbol 0. Okay, so BK is considered as 0 in the receiver. Because in the transmitter side, what happens, for BK equal to 0, the amplitude level that is produced by pre-coded duo binary scheme is plus or minus 2 volt. Okay, higher amplitude level. So in the threshold detector, if the received amplitude level is greater than 1 volt, that threshold value 1 volt, then the value given for BK is 0. Okay, so this is the binary value given to BK. So if CK is less than 1 volt, this threshold value, okay, so for a lower amplitude level, then BK is identified as 1, identified as higher phase value. So that is why I told you here non-linear coordination takes place. Okay, so this is the thing. Okay, so this is regarding pre-coded duo binary scheme or pre-coded duo binary signaling. I hope you understand what is the reason to go for a pre-coded duo binary scheme from duo binary scheme. If you like my video, kindly comment, like and share. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Meet you again in the next video. Until then, bye. Thank you.